Welcome back everyone, this is Chirag from dconcloud.com. So in this quick tutorial I would like to show that how you can create a object storage bucket on Alibaba Cloud platform. So let's get started. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. It will help me to motivate myself and help me to create such kind of content more and more. So once you logged in with your Alibaba account, you can customize your front page or dashboard. They have a new feature I found as they are maturing day by day. So they have a lot of new features coming here and there. So you can create, or maybe your view will be different. So let's go to object storage service. So you can find it from the product and services. I bookmark it. So that is why it is showing me here as a shortcut. So object storage service is to store blob. So blobs are binary large object. As this is a fresh account, so it is asking me to activate now. So let's click on activate. So if you have used any other cloud platform, so in Amazon world it is equivalent of S3, in GCP it is Google Cloud Storage, as well as if you think about Microsoft Azure, so this is equivalent of Azure Blob Storage. Here it is asking me to some security risk, because I believe it is due to I am logged in via my RAM user rather than the root user. So let's proceed with the verification. I created this account very new. So let me see. It is asking me that it will verify and it will deduct $1. So help me to enable the service or not. And here you can see I am able to enable this OSS service now. So I just click. I believe because this is a fresh account and they want to check the things, so they verify. And here we can see it is saying that order complete. It is just the mechanism which Alibaba Cloud created. It is not going to deduct anything. Even in the free tier or the free trial, it is giving 100 GB of space to use, which is much more than I found any other cloud provider offering in their free trial. So if you are a developer, you want to host your images or maybe some kind of a video content or a backup, you can think to use Alibaba Cloud platform. I am started liking it very much, as more and more I am exploring lot of feature, lot of what I can say, my cloud understanding coming from a different platform is helping me to understand it quickly. So again, let me start again with the object storage service, and this time it is giving the dashboard of object storage service, or just simply let's say call it as object storage, and few options to create a bucket, some resource plan, cross-region replication, some tool recommended services. So I will explore these one by one. So this is just a bucket creation video. I'm not going to explore the other option like cross-region replication or any tools. So let's start it with creating a bucket. Here you can see the bucket button is there, as well as you can click on bucket, and then again it will ask to create bucket. So I'm going to click here, and it is giving the options. So again, keep remember the bucket name need to be unique globally, and its scope is in Alibaba Cloud overall cloud platform. So let's start with, I'm just going to type Chirag Cloud, because in my another account I already created on my name Chirag Nayyar, so I know that is not present. Even let's check and let's see if it is getting filled or not. So here you can see. So let's put something Chirag Cloud, and I want to select a region. You can select if you want to put it in China or any other region, all India, Indonesia, Singapore and US, and Malaysia is there. I'm going to select the Singapore because I'm based out of Singapore. And after that you can see it is giving the endpoint. So they have a regional endpoint. As you change the region, you will see this endpoint will change. After that you can select the storage class, standard, infrequent access and archive. There is also the cold archive is also in preview, but it is not available in right now most of the regions, as it is a preview going. But you can see, understand from your, if you already played with the object storage services on another cloud platform, This is the straightforward thing, so I'm going to select the standard one. This is something, a new feature we will explore in some upcoming video, so let it be disabled. And the same versioning is there, I'm not going to enable it, let it be disabled. By default bucket is private, so let's select the private access control list. Encryption method, it is by default none, but I suggest at least to go with object storage service manage, which is the keys are managed by Alibaba cloud platform. Or if you have some kind of compliance, you need to follow your own key rotation and permissions, you can follow the key management service key. But I am okay with the OSS manage right now, so let's select this. And after that, real-time query and schedule backup we will explore in the later video. So I'm just going to click, and you will be able to see that bucket is created in just a blink of eye. And after that, it is showing us some information about this. This is some endpoint, even it is giving you the public endpoint, as it is mentioned, access over internet. I suggest you test it, because as we select the ACL private, so it will give you the error. So I just put it in my URL and it is giving me the error. So let's come back and see a couple of other options. And from here you can see files. If you want to upload something, click on upload. And I'm just going to add one image I have, so adding the image, and it's there already uploaded because it's a small content. I can see some image preview and option, as well as I can say this is kind of a signed URL for this. Obviously I'm going to delete this image, so that even if you try to type my this signed URL, it will not open. So you can play with this and you will get the idea. So that's it about the OSS. You can just start playing and understanding what's there. On my blog, one article is published. If you would like to follow the step-by-step information from the article link is also in the description. So feel free to read, give it a feedback also, give it your own view, as well as try and share in your circle. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And you can check the another playlist in which I have created that how to create the Alibaba account, as well as how to create the RAM user and set up the MFA. All those step-by-step articles also available in the blog. So take care guys, see you next time, bye bye.